Hi, my name's Bree, and I'm here today to demonstrate part two of our series of eLodgement changes. You will have already read through a summary of the eLodgement changes on our website and watched part one of this series. This demonstration covers changes to the hearing date area, the automatic acceptance process, and what happens to your lodgement if it fails to be automatically processed. Let's begin. Here is our sample lodgement. Where we are in this lodgement is we have selected our action as corporations. Our case type is winding up. Our originating application as our originating process, Form 2. We have selected our parties for this action and applied the number 1 as our sequence. We have accepted the system generated file title. And these are all criteria for automatic acceptance eligibility in the area of corporations. We now have the ability to select our preferred hearing date. So let's now cover the changes to the hearing date area. You now have the ability to view available hearing dates within an appropriate window and then select your preference. The system automatically displays the available hearing dates within a 4 to 6 week window unless you have selected a date outside the window using the request hearing on a particular date option earlier in the lodgement process. You can view the dates that are available here on the left hand side. So in our sample lodgement, we have dates available from the 7th of February right through to the 3rd of March. If you need to list multiple matters together, you can now view the capacity for each sitting on the right hand side under the files allocated column. You can see how many files have been allocated to each sitting and can now start to group your matters on a particular day to better manage when you attend court. So you can see here that there are no files allocated to any of our sittings between the 7th of February right through to the 3rd of March. You must select a hearing date preference in order to continue through the lodgement process. So for our sample lodgement, I'm going to select the 17th of February 2017. Once you have selected your preference and pressed the continue button, your hearing date preference will be displayed in the hearing date area for you to review. You can edit your selected preference at any stage by selecting the edit button prior to finalising your lodgement. Please note, if you have selected a hearing date but do not finalise your lodgement within a reasonable time, the system may time out or your allocated spot may be taken by other users who may have finalised their lodgement ahead of yours. When you finalise your lodgement, the system will create the hearing event. Your selected listing details will be displayed on the Notice of Filing and Hearing cover sheet attached to your originating application, which I will now demonstrate. So I've selected my preference. I'm now going to select the continue button. I now need to acknowledge that this is the fee that I'm about to pay. I can select my method of payment, continue with my credit card, select the payee, and click continue. I don't wish to save this lodgement as a template, so click no. And now I'm ready to finalise my lodgement. Now by finalising my lodgement, the system is going to automatically accept this corporation's lodgement. So now let's cover the automatic acceptance process so you can see these changes in action. Finalise my lodgement. I select my credit card that I wish to pay with. And now I receive the message that my documents have been successfully lodged and to please note the lodgement ID for future reference. So before I demonstrate how the system has automatically accepted this corporation's lodgement, Firstly, understand what auto acceptance is. Essentially, it means that bankruptcy creditors petitions and corporations winding up applications will no longer need to be manually processed by a registry unless there is an exception. And I will cover some of these exceptions later on in the demonstration. The types of documents that will be automatically accepted are, in the federal court, our creditors petition, form B6, in corporations, our federal court originating process form 2, and in the federal circuit court, our creditors petition form B6. And any document types that are already candidates for automatic acceptance that are filed together with the originating document types I have just mentioned, for example, affidavits. You can track the status and processing of your lodgement via your lodgement history tab. So if I click the lodgement history tab up here, I'm now presented with all of my queues in which I can track the status of my lodgement. If I now click the accepted queue, I can see that the lodgement we just finalised and submitted to the court has been displayed at the top of the list, VID 1 of 2017, and our file title that was automatically generated by the system which we accepted was Deputy Commissioner of Taxation versus Catalogue Solutions in the Victorian Registry, and it was our corporations action. I can view my lodgement by clicking the view button, and I can now access my stamped documents by clicking on the hyperlink here. Click open. And I'm presented with our notice of filing and hearing cover page attached to my originating application. I can see the file number, I can see the file title, and I can also see the hearing date that I selected of the 17th of February 2017 at 9:30 a.m. Our listing has been created for first directions. You would have also received an email notification containing your stamped documents as per current functionality. You will have noticed that at no stage was registry review required for these types of applications. I mentioned earlier that there are some situations where your application may fail to be automatically accepted by the system. When this happens, the lodgement will be queued as per current functionality for manual review and processing by registry. Some scenarios where this will occur are if you have selected a document option, for example, suppression, urgent, or confidentiality, against any of your uploaded document types, the hearing date nominated was outside the 4 to 6 week available window, the file title that was generated by the system was rejected, or you uploaded a supporting document type that requires a listing together with your originating application. For example, an interlocutory application. Or if you have selected save and complete later during the lodgement process, or if the lodgement failed to stamp correctly. These are all scenarios where your lodgement may not be automatically accepted by the system and will be queued for manual review and processing by registry. Again, remember you can always track the status and progress of your lodgement by monitoring your lodgement history queues up here. This concludes the demonstration of our eLodgement changes. We hope you have taken away the additional benefits of filing your documents online with the federal court. Please visit our website www.fedcourt.gov.au for further information.